everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today we have got a very special video because we are going to be doing a creative showcase haul and the Christmas collection at Lush. So that's very exciting. I've got lovely Samantha here to help me.
Hello.
And I've got Millie just down here as well, who helped us source all of this amazing stuff because she worked very hard at the showcase over the last few days. I think we're just going to get in there because there's quite a lot to do, and we're going to tell you a little bit about the products as we go as well. This might be a bit of a long video, maybe I'll do it in two parts, I'm not quite sure yet. Cool, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we're going to talk about is the showcase. So the showcase is really a fancy name for our manager's meeting. As you probably know from various vlogs and videos that we work for Lush, this is a really exciting way of completely showing everything that Lush is about. Music, we did a kitchen, we've got all the stuff about careers, we've got the hair lab, we've got makeup and bubbles. And this was a really good opportunity for the managers to see all the new things. It was also open to the public as well, so people, journalists, press, they could come along and see everything. So we got a couple of things from the showcase, so we're going to show you those first. So the creative showcase took place at Tobacco Dock in East London, and it was over the Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday of this past week. You can actually watch a vlog that I've done, which is the video before this, if you want to see more about the showcase and what it was like on the day. We're going to talk about a couple of things we got swag wise first. First of all, there's this lovely t-shirt. So this is the fighting animal testing t-shirt. So obviously this is very important to Lush, one of their core values. And yeah, it's just a nice big roomy t-shirt. Black and white is our uniform, so it matches. You wear it on your floor. Next is this apron.
Ooh, love Lush.
So obviously based on the like I Love New York print, and this is a long apron, so it goes all the way down to your knees, doesn't it, this one?
That one comes in a tote bag as well. So just get up there.
Whoop. There were lots of lovely tote bags at the event. All the black items in the t-shirt are 100% cotton. These ones are made at Westford Mill, ethically produced and chlorine free. So I pop that in there. This one is made by Rewrap, which is a women's cooperative based in India. They screen print their own fabrics, and we use them to make bags. They're 100% fair trade cotton, and this one is might look familiar. We have a lovely gift called Honey Gift.
Maybe yeah, it's honey, isn't it?
Yeah, just Honey Gift. This one's got a lovely pocket as well. And then we also have a lanyard in the same vein. Exclusive to Oxford Street this year are two shower gels that we've had in the past, but you can only buy them in London for this Christmas.
So first one is Ponches. So this one has a little shot of tequila in there. It's boozy, it's orangey, lovely and zesty. One of my favourites from my first Christmas that I worked at Lush.
One of the other ones they've got is the Twilight Shower Gel. This one's got lots of lovely French lavender and tonka in there, and it's so nice just to go to bed with, isn't it?
Oh, dreamy.
So good. So next one we're going to talk about is a ballistic called Metamorphosis, which we actually don't have any of the ingredients for. It's part of the new perfume range at Lush, and it looks like this. You can watch a video on the Lush player of Manami Frost making this very ballistic. Not this very ballistic. These ballistics,
yes.
But it smells really good, really spicy. How would you describe that? Like peppery.
Yeah, it's got.
It just made me think of something, and I can't think what it is.
Yeah, no.
It's like cinnamony. Yeah, if you like experimenting, you'll probably like this one.
So they've also launched 12 new perfumes, and they're part of the Volume 4, isn't that right? Yeah. So I picked one up called I'm Home. It's a little bit like this. This one, it's got fair trade vanilla absolute in it, and cocoa absolute as well. It's quite a sweet and spicy kind of warming scent to it, a bit like baking Christmas cookies.
The idea was like when you come in, you've been on a long journey, you've been away from home,
yeah.
That feeling of
familiarity
and comfortingness.
Yeah,
comfortingness. Well, we've had a beating, but
yeah,
we have this soap here, lovely pink one. This was exclusive to the Lush players, who did an amazing job all the way through the showcase. They made sure everyone was very entertained, and they wore amazing costumes even though it was literally like 35 degrees in the venue. This one smells like Nevermind the Ballistics, which we'll get onto in a minute, and it was part of the guitars that they had for their punk band. And you can only, this was, there was three of them made, right? Oh, so there's four of them made, that's it. I've got a little chunk, which you can use too. Two of them got cut up, and the other two are in Oxford Street, and they're going to use them for performances throughout the Christmas season. It's very exciting, isn't it? There are four shower gels that are released for Christmas in all stores. The first one is good old Snowfairy. Here we go. So this is the old festive favourite. It comes back every single year and it smells like bubblegum. The other one is Rose Jam. This one smells like the Rose Jam Bubble Rune and the Rose Argan and all the rose things.
So another one returning part of the Halloween range is Lord of Misrule Shower Cream, which is vanilla, patchouli and black pepper, really earthy, and you've got cocoa butter in there to make it really soft and creamy as well. Then the new one this year is Bubbly, and this one has fresh grape juice, an orange oil and smells like the Celebrate body lotion we've had the previous years and the first snow dusting powder.
And the Golden Wonder Ballistic.
Ignore this claim. So excited. We have a smell of this one.
Good. This one is inspired by Bucks Fizz. If you like Bucks Fizz on Christmas morning, this is the one that you need.
Yeah.
So now on to jellies, the first one we've got. I'm gonna hold this up. The snowman jelly. So this one is the same smell as the carrot soap that we have at Easter. It's very slippery. We had this one last year as well. And it's the shape of a lovely snowman.
We've got Santa's belly, which has had a bit of a makeover this year. We had it in last year for the first time. You can see it looks a bit like a buckle. It smells like the So White bath bomb and the shower gel we've done before as well. And it's got like an apple scented jelly with little stars in the middle as well, so really sparky.
Like a big roll of jelly. The last jelly we've got this year is Papa Noel. This one has got in it lots of tangerine oil, lime oil and organic orange. So this one is made as a face wash. Our one is a little bit ripped up, unfortunately, but I can kind of show you, sort of half show you. So it comes like in a big beard and you can wear it on your face in the bath. Like this. Look, a sad bit. This one's a sad bit. But it's quite a big one, and I think that's really exciting because Lush have never done face jelly before.
No.
So next up with shower, there's so many things in this range this year, honestly guys, is the Snowfairy Body Conditioner. So this one is a lovely pink conditioner and it has that gorgeous Snowfairy fragrance to it.
And the next body conditioner we've got is Christingle, which you might remember from last year. And this one, you've got lots of spearmint oil, peppermint oil, menthol crystals, really minty. You can't open it.
Makes you really cold, doesn't it?
Yeah, really
chilly. Makes you want to get in your blanket and nice hot water bottle. Nice toasty socks.
Yeah. It's good to refresh like after a busy day at work. I actually use this a lot in the summer this year.
The last thing in the shower range is salt and peppermint bark, which is returning for another year. Me and Sam got a bit obsessed with this, so did Lex. And it smells really good, a bit like the maple. A bit like the maypole soap that we have in store. This one has got loads of salt to scrub and lots of peppermint in it, so it leaves you feeling lovely and fresh and tingly.
Ooh, I like that one.
So we have two new lip products this year. First of all, the Sugarplum Fairy, which is a new lip scrub, and it's this lovely purple shade. This one has got Sweet Wild Orange in there, sort of, it smells kind of,
it's a bit like the comforter.
A bit space girly.
Yeah.
So that's very nice. And then to match it, they've also bought out a lip tint. So this is a lip tint and it has a lovely purple shade to it. So a returning favourite is Santa Baby Lip Scrub. This one has got lots of dates and figs.
Cherries and dates
in jojoba oil. And this one is Santa Baby, which is the same as this one. This one's got extract of cinnamon and mandarin in it. So now we're going to talk about yet another returning favourite. This is Bûche de Noël. So this one obviously has ground almonds in there. It has cranberries in there.
Has it got brandy in there?
Oh, I believe it does have brandy in there. And this one this year has got a little bit of gold luster just on the seaweed, which is really softening. Not gold luster, the seaweed. It's very softening.
Yes. Okay, then this one is a new product. It's Sleepy Body Lotion. This one shares the same smell as the Twilight Shower Gel, Twilight Bath Bomb, the lavender.
I'm not in there.
Oh, and it's got like a purpley kind of colour. As you can see, we've gone quite into this one a lot.
So another one is this little lady. She's called Goth Fairy. And, well, it might not be a lady actually. It may be a man fairy. And this is a new shimmer bar to match the shimmy shimmy. This one has got lots of silver glitter in there. So if you like Space Girl and you miss it dearly, then this is going to be a really nice one to go for. So last year we had a really amazing soap called Yognog Soap. This year it's come back as a roulade. So this has the same smell as the Yognog soap, just in a lovely creamy roulade. It's actually slipping out my hands as I speak. The paper around this side is made of melon, so it's lovely and softening in the bath.
And joining that one for Christmas is Candy Cane. Candy Cane. It's, when it's in a whole log, it looks a bit like a candy cane with red and white stripes. How many times can I say candy cane?
Candy cane!
And it smells quite sweet and minty. Bit like the maypole soap that we have all year round. So if you like that one, you're gonna love this.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Right, we're going to go on to soaps next. This one is Igloo soap. So this is actually the top of the igloo, and it's gonna be like building blocks into an igloo shape. This one has a really gorgeous rose smell. The rose that we use in this soap is picked by hand in Turkey, and it's part of our slush fund, which you can find out more about on our website. This one actually smells like Turkish Delight, like if you open the fresh box of Turkish Delight, and it always has like a little bounce to it as well. It's also got lots of Sicilian lemon in it.
The next soap we've got is Magic Wand. So in stores it's not actually going to look like this. It's going to be a bit like the Serendipity and Maypole, where it's in like a round rod type
fellow.
Okay. Cylinder. Like a magic wand. So this one smells just like the inside of fire. Very smoky. Mm. But warming.
Mm. I like it. It's like a chai latte.
Yes.
This year Reindeer Rock has had a makeover, and now it's in these individual little pebbles, and it still has the reindeer in there like the cave paintings. This year it smells a bit different.
Jasmine,
like very jasminey. It's got neroleum rose in there as well, and this is really useful because my mum always makes me cut a big block out the reindeer to get a singular reindeer. So this year I won't have to do that.
So another one of our soaps is Santa's Postbox, which is a small one in gifts, a little bit like this, but each shop will have the big one.
Kind of fruity. Stars. Shooting Star soap is going to be a lovely big round soap, a bit like Honey I Washed Your Kids. You can see all the soaps in my vlog if you have watched that video, you know exactly what I'm talking about. This one has got lots of bergamot, Sicilian lemon and star fruit puree in it.
Back for another year is Bait Alaska. This one's got lemon myrtle, grapefruit. It's really zesty, really zingy soap, and it looks like a globe.
A
snow globe, in fact. Yeah, it's just really refreshing.
It's great for those winter blues.
Yeah.
Returning is Snow Cake Soap. This is our classic almond fragrance soap. It's got lots of rose in there. And this year it looks like a really cute little castle. It will be a big castle on the display.
Is it called Snowcastle?
It's called Snowcastle. This year we have a new fun product. It's called Elf on Shelf. And this one, if you twist it around, comes with little legs. So a few years ago we did a jelly called Jilted Elf, and if you liked that jelly, it was a green sparkly one, then you'll definitely like this. It's exactly the same fragrance.
Ooh.
And this one has all the colours you need to make an elf. We've got another new one here. This is called Reindeer and Robin. And this one comes with chocolate chips. And this one smells exactly like the Santa Baby lip scrub and lip tint. So if you like that kind of like dates and cherry sort of fragrance, you like this one. It's like cherry coke. A returning favorite is Santa Fun. So the Santa Fun, so this one smells like Christmas Eve bubble bar, which we discontinued a few years ago, and obviously it has the colors in it to make Santa. And it's really nice. It was sort of made to use on your bedtime bath before Christmas.
Next one is Snowfairy.
Woo!
And this one comes with wings and a wand, as you can see.
I've got them here.
Yep. And it of course smells like bubblegum and pear drops, just like the classic Snowfairy shower gel.
Last year we had two different dusting powders. This year a returning one is the fairy dust. It was so popular that we thought we'd bring it back. And this one's obviously, like I said, smells like Snowfairy. And it has a really pretty pink shimmer in there.
And a new one this year is Mr. Sandman. And this one smells just like Twilight.
I like Twilight.
And there's a little shimmer in there as well.
Very exciting.
Silver dusting in there too.
I'm so pleased about all the Twilight stuff this year. It's one of my favourites. Every time it comes in the kitchen, I like try and buy it. So very excited.
Now we're moving on to the bubble bar wands, and we've got magic wand,
returning fairy,
snow fairy bell. Scent with a little bell on the top with some silver ribbon as well.
Another returning one is the magical Christmas wand. It has a little bell on it, and this one smells like cinders. So lots of cinnamon and clove in there, and sweet almond oil.
So we've also got two new ones, and first up we got Jester, which, fun little guy, isn't he? And this one has also got a little bell and a ribbon, and this one smells like the sun fragrance, so really lovely bright and orange. And the seeds, perfume, you smell it.
I like it. Has a bit like a bright side bubble bar as well.
Yes.
This one is Santasaurus, and this one is a new one for this year. It smells like the Honey I Washed the Kids soap, and it's full of sweet wild orange. Now we're going to move on to our bath range. Bath is a really big part of Lush, as most people know, and this year we've got some fantastic bath bombs and bubbles coming out. So I'm going to start with an old favourite, the Father Christmas bath bomb. This one has got the same smell as Snowfairy, and it has a hidden green core in there as well.
We've got a new one that comes in at Halloween called Autumn Leaf, and this one's sticking around till Christmas as far as I believe.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, and it's got a really grassy scent. If you remember grass shower gel, so that you'll like this. It's pretty much the same, isn't it?
Oh, it is. I love it.
Gonna get like 10 of these.
10. Definitely. This is a good one as well if you like the green bubble rune, but it's leaving us. And that's a nice one to stock up on. Next, we have got So White. This one is back again this year. This one looks a bit more like an apple this time. It has a little green leaf on it, and it has that lovely sort of crisp apple scent, just like Santa's belly shower gel.
Yeah.
Do we know if this one has colour in it?
It's green.
Green. There you go. So this one goes green in the bath. So a lovely green apple.
And then we've got the Christmas penguin. It's come back. Look at it. Oh, look at that little guy. So this one smells the same as the olive branch shower gel. It's got vine leaf, bergamot, and mandarin. The pop in the bath bubble bar is the same as well, that we do all year round. We're now keeping that.
We are.
Back.
So yeah, pop in bath, not leaving us. Very good.
Staying in store.
So another old favourite is Candy Mountain. It's a real favourite every Christmas. We get loads of people coming in for it. Has that same fragrance as Creamy Candy and Rockstar Soap. Lovely sweet vanilla-y fragrance. And this one has got a little bit of luster on that as well.
Very cool. Then another returning favourite from last year is Peeping Santa. This one smells really creamy, like strawberries. The strawberry feels massage bar that's all year round, and the yummy mummy shower cream that came out on Mother's Day this year.
This one's inspired by those little strawberry treats that you make with cream and strawberries
and chocolate chips.
Moving on to a Halloween product this time. This is very special. It's a brand new product, and it is this one here. So this is the Boo. This is Boo, a bath melt, and it smells like ginger perfume. If you've shopped at Lush for a good few years, you'll know that this is a really like warming, zesty kind of a fragrance. This one has actually got a bit of bubble bar in there as well, so it kind of foams as well as melts.
Oh, I didn't know that. And then another Halloween one is the Lord of Misrule bath bomb. The Lord of Misrule, like the shower cream, smells vanilla and patchouli, and it's red wine kind of blood colour in
The next one is a Christmas one, and it's Northern Lights. Some people know that a few years ago we did one called Northern Lights, and it was like a thinner kind of stick bath bomb, but unfortunately it would break a lot. And this year they've made it really super strong, and it still has that lovely smell of Christmas Eve bomb bath.
Now we've got another Halloween. This is a new one this year, and it's the pumpkin. I think this one kind of smells like pumpkin spice latte, and it's got a bit of a kind of tang of the avocado co-wash that Lush does.
Yeah, I never noticed that avocado co-wash thing before, but it does. Back to Christmas, and a very old favourite returning. This is Ruby Red Slippers. This year it has come in an actual slipper shape, which is nice. This one is the same fragrance as Potion Body Lotion that we had a few years ago, which is a sort of rose and carnation fragrance. And then for Christmas it was called Ruby Red Slippers, but it was just a round one that was covered in red glitter, and now we have that instantly. I'm very, very pleased. I absolutely love this fragrance.
And another Christmas one is Butter Bear. So this one's got cocoa butter and synthetic musk for that lovely sweet vanilla reason. Yeah, it's just like the butterball bath one that Lush does all year round, just in the shape of a bear.
So now for another Halloween one. This one is called The Monster's Ball. And this one here smells like calacas, which was a product that we had a few years ago for Halloween. It's inspired by sort of Mexican Day of the Dead. And this one has got loads of lime and neroli in there. It's a good monster.
So this one was one of my favourites the past few Christmases, and it's Golden Wonder. So it's in the shape of a Christmas present, and am I right in thinking it takes about
7 days
to make? Yeah, and it's got lots of different layers, and it's got the same fragrance as the bubbly shower gel that's coming out this year. And I don't know how you describe that really.
Kind of orangey fragrance in there.
Yeah.
But not orange like the lava lamp.
No.
It's a bit different. But yeah, it's inspired by Bucks Fizz, just like the bubbly shower gel. So it's something a bit special. This one is Luxury Lush Pud. It smells like the twilight shower gel again. So this year you can bathe in it, you can wash with it, you can
moisturize
with it, and then dust with it afterwards. So it really is, you can just completely cover yourself in the twilight fragrance. This one has got lots of little colored bits that float out into the bath and make the bath look pretty and sweaty. Now for a very exciting product that is inspired by one of my most favorite recording artists ever in history, and it is Snowie, obviously named after David Bowie. So it has his iconic lightning on there. This one smells amazing, a bit like the Frozen bath bomb, which has got loads of grapefruit rose and neroli in there. It smells amazing, I love it. I'm so pleased that they paid homage to him this year.
For Halloween, we got the sparkly pumpkin. It's there. Sparkly pumpkin is like a spicy orangey kind of scent, I suppose.
Yeah.
Boot chew in there.
Has a cinnamon stick in it for its little.
What's
this? Stalk.
Stalk
in there. This one was a fan favourite last year.
So this next bath bomb is one we've had a few years, but now it's had a bit of a makeover again. This is Shoot for the Stars bath bomb. And it's a little bit like the lava lamp, they're all year round now. So it's got the same fragrance as Honey, I Watched the Kids, Santasaurus bubble bar, and also cocoa butter stars. So
I think it's nice, it's kind of like a grown up version.
Yeah.
I love the look of it, it's so pretty.
It's a little bit more simple, and I quite like that.
The next one is a brand new one for this year. This one is called Never Mind the Ballistics, and it has a duo. Sort of bath bomb, so it has bath melt on the outside and then it has normal ballistic on the bottom. This one obviously inspired by London's 1970 punk scene, and it smells really fruity and sweet. The outside of this one actually has banana scent as well, so it's super softening. I love it.
Always really good. And another one that we've had seen before, it's Snow Angel. So this is another one that's got like a butter kind of layer to it on the bottom and a bath on the top. And it shares the same smell as snow cake soap, so kind of that sweet marzipan.
Because they're just going to hear about it right now. So this next one, again, is a new one for this year, and it is mistletoe. It's got some really nice detailing on the top that looks like mistletoe. And this one smells like fairy jasmine, which is a very old a bath bomb. And it's got loads and loads of jasmine in, obviously, and loads of glitter. But this is a really pretty soft jasmine. It's not like Lust or Flying Fox or anything like that. So I absolutely love this one. Very pretty.
Last but not least is Stardust. So this one, obviously a white star shape bath bomb with a little bit of blue in there, and I think there was little stars in this one as well last year, wasn't there?
Yeah.
So I'm sure they're in there again this year, and it smells quite similar to the mistletoe bath bomb. It's a little bit sweeter, I think, a little bit like the silky underwear dusting powder. I like some.
When it's in the bathroom. Now we're going to move on to knot wraps. We only have two of the knot wrap range, and they're both for Halloween. So the first one we have is Moon Phases, and it looks like this. This one, feel free to pull it up, is made of green spun, which is made out of two recycled bottles, and it has all the different phases of the moon on it. Very nice. The second knot wrap that we have for Halloween is this really cool eyeball knot wrap. This one is from Rewrap, as we mentioned before, the women's cooperative in India. And this one's got loads of like gross eyeballs on it, which I really like, the neon eyeballs. There are a couple more knot wraps for Christmas. Unfortunately, we don't have any with us, but we do have a very special knot wrap gift with us, and it's this one here. So this guy is called Pip. So Pip is a very special little guy. He's got a butterball in his head, and then he's got a blush pud in his butt. And this is really nice because it's sort of taken over from the Mr. Frosty's. So it's a nice one to have. So when he is not wrapped up, he looks like that. So he's quite a cute little penguin face. What could you wrap up from this? Your oranges to take to work. Could re-gift this one as well. There is a product this year that is a gift exclusive. It is this one here, and it's called Satsuma. Just that you would normally get one in your stocking. Here it is. It looks like classic Satsuma. Even has like a little label on it like you would get. And this one just has a really beautiful orange fragrance. Nice and sweet. So this obviously has been quite a long video because there's been so much to show this year for Christmas. Obviously some of them are a little bit bashed around. That's because they travelled all the way from London to Southampton, so you guys could all see them. But I hope that they've been completely clear for you to be able to have a little look. The Halloween range launches in Lush from the 23rd of September, and all the Christmas stuff is in store from the 1st of October. This year they've tried really hard to make all the products self-preserving, so we don't use any safe synthetic preservatives at all, and nearly every single thing in the range is vegan. So I think that's really nice. Nice to like improve our like ethical footprint on that. I think that's everything. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to this channel. I'll post everything in the description box as well, just so you guys can see what each one of them are called, and I'll try and find some prices as well. And yeah, fantastic. We'll see you very soon.
Bye.
Bye. You gonna shout bye?
Bye.
Bye. Millie! Suddenly she just gets herself sorted, and then you know. Sorry.
Thank you.